All right. Let's start our test, Mama. We've got the Vortex Vanquish in 8 by 26. I love the feel of this unit, frankly. You can hold this one-handed. And like I said, and I observed before, I do like the focusing mechanism on this. It's just easy. 8x26 right here. And right here in my daughter's hands, we've got the 10x26 unit up against the Athlon Midas 10x25. So we've got a 10x26 up against a 10x25. 1 millimeter difference in the objective lens. Our visual is pretty simple. We've got flowers, we've got trees in the distance. Let's make some observations, shall we? I'll tell you what, I am liking this 8x26 unit for sure. I've got a wide field of view and very, very simple to focus with this focus knob. No slop in this focus knob whatsoever. And I've got contrast. I've got a good sight picture. I've got a fairly wide field of view. But the real test is being done right here. One above another. We've got the Athlon going up head to head with the Vortex Vanquish. Now, nice and loud for the people. Love, what are your thoughts?
I like this one better.
The Athlons?
Uh-huh.
Why?
Oh, I'm looking at the Scarecrow really far away and it just looks clearer with the Athlon.
How's the field of view difference between these two?
Athlon's got a higher field of view.
A wider field of view, yeah. I agree with you on that.
Not by much.
What about the color and the contrast?
It's better on the Athlon.
Both the color and the contrast?
Yeah.
We've got argon purged on the Athlons. Midas, they're argon purged as opposed to nitrogen purged on the Vortex. That's not going to make any difference in color or contrast, just a distinction in the cost of the gas purging that these units have. What about form factor? Which form factor do you like? They're totally different, right? Yeah, I agree with you. The Vortex form factor is definitely very nice to hold, right?
Mm-hmm. This one's too... There's nothing to grip on this one.
Yeah, you've got... See, now, the difference is... Okay, these Athlons, I don't know why it is, but they didn't do this armoring all the way up and down this unit. The armoring is just in this section right here. This is magnesium and the barrel is magnesium. And therefore, it's a little harder to hold on to. And also, you're talking about the size difference between the two, right? It's a natural size difference between the two. One thing that I do note is that this 8x26 unit, I am actually liking this unit. And the reason that I am is because, you know, that 2x less magnification is making it very easy for me to avail a sight picture. And because the field of view is naturally wider with less magnification, I perceive brightness and clarity more so than that 10x26 unit in the Vanquish. I am liking this particular unit. I really do. It's easy on the hands, easy to get a sight picture, and the sight picture itself is wide. It's got good contrast. I don't know about low light yet. We'll test that later. But I am enjoying using this, and the weight is just fine enough, just light enough so that it's substantial, but not a burden around my neck. Now, one thing that immediately when I unboxed this unit you saw was that the eye covers, just terrible. They don't attach at all to the strap because they don't have the ability to be attached to the strap. So you know I'm not going to be using those eye covers at all. And the objective lens don't come with a cover. So all in all, for $90-somewhat, I am going to be keeping this Vertex 8x26 for sure and adding it to the collection. Now, you guys haven't seen the strap that comes with it. Let me show that to you. The strap is pretty plain vanilla. It doesn't have the Vortex logo on it at all. It's only about 1 inch, I would say, across. It's a fairly cheap nylon, but it does its job. And I'm sure that Vertex didn't look at this and say, we're going to add yet another item to this in order to make the price a little bit higher. I think they wanted to come in under that $100 price point, which is intelligent for them. They made a very nice unit. I'm talking about this 8x26 unit now. And I'm liking it, frankly. I wish that the Athlons, can you hold that up, love? I wish that the Athlons had a 8x25 unit, but it doesn't. The Athlon Midas only comes in 10x25, and that's why we put it head to head with this Vortex 10x26. But having used it, Mama, you think that you like and prefer the Athlons more. And what were the reasons for that?
It's a wider field of view, and the color and clarity is better, I think, in this one.
Color and clarity better with that one. But look at the form factors. I mean, close down, if you will, the Athlon unit. Let me take the Vortex unit from you.
I'm not gonna drop it.
I didn't think that you were gonna drop it. But yeah, the form factor, people, for the 10x26 Vortex and the 8x26 is the exact same, right? They're the exact same thing. The only difference is the magnification. This one being the 10x26, this one being the 8x26. But, okay, you did that without me capturing it on camera, love. Go ahead and fold it out. See, that double bridge design is fantastic. It really is. Put it together. And just show it to the... look at that. Just look at that unit. right? I mean, it's just so convenient. Now, put this one in your other hand. What about weight?
They're about the same.
You perceive it to be the same, love, but it's actually not.
Is this one heavier?
The Vortex is heavier.
Yeah, they seem the same.
You're talking about 4 ounces. The Vortex is 4 ounces heavier. 4 ounces heavier for the Vortex. It comes in at 12 point something ounces. The Athlon is coming in at 8.8 ounces on my testing, but it is advertised as 8.5. But you made an observation about the Athlons that you would like changed or upgraded a bit, love. What was that?
It's too slippery.
Yeah.
I wish it had this grip.
Yeah, the Vortex does have a very, very nice grip surface. You can really get a hold of this. It's easy to use. This unit is just easy to use. Vortex did a great job with this. It really did do a great job with this. But I can tell you, I'm going to be keeping this 8x26 unit for sure. But the 10x26 unit, not so much. I think it has limitations, as my daughter noted, against the Athlon Midas UHD Generation 2 unit, that are substantial. The contrast, the color, it's just substantial, a difference between the two. So, needless to say, we're definitely going to be hanging on to our Athlon Midases, and the Vortex is going to be going back in the 10 power. There just is no reason to hold on to the 10x26 unit Vanquish. But, you know, you are talking about a cost difference. What do you think the cost is between the two, love? The Vortex Vanquish 10x26, how much do you think those are?
$150.
Actually, there are less than $100. But how much do you think the Athlon Midas UHD 10x25s are?
$150.
You would be right almost about that. That's $167. So the Athlon unit is definitely more expensive. And for those of you that are trying to come in at under $100, hey, this is a very nice unit, okay? It's a very nice unit. But we are comparing 10 power between two units, and the clear winner in this case is definitely this, the Athlon Midas.